Good to wake up in the morning with no assignments, coursework, or exams due, and you're just like waking up slowly and do your morning routine, you do your Pilates, and I don't know, like have nice breakfast, or just like having the morning for yourself is such a blessing, because my day personally depends on how I start my mornings. And if I have to sacrifice one part of my morning routine just for college or because I have like assignments due and I need to be in a rush, I will feel pressed and just depressed during that day. And that used to happen to me during this semester and especially the finals week. Last week was probably the craziest for this entire year. I sacrificed my sleep, my mental health, my daily routine just to get done with those finals. During the past couple days, I used to get only like 5 or 4 hours of sleep. I would go to bed like 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. and then wake up early and then take the exam on that day. But yesterday I finally got to sleep for 9 hours and that felt so good. I usually don't wear my watch to bed, but I was curious yesterday about my sleeping cycle, and since I went to bed early and I really want to see how my sleeping cycle changes and how it makes me feel, because this week really made me realize the importance of sleep. I always heard people talking about that. It's even scientifically proven, but I would never prioritize sleep. I would probably like survive on caffeine or something. But getting enough sleep the last night really proved me how important it is in order to wake up with clear mind, with rest and good mood, and especially for like hormonal balance. For breakfast, I'm gonna have these overnight oats that I made yesterday. Fun fact, that's my very first time trying overnight oats. I'm a huge oatmeal lover and I use oats in like basically everything, pancakes, oatmeal, like I add oats everywhere, but I've never tried overnight ones. So for this one right here, I used 1/2 cup of oats, milk, cheese seeds, Greek yogurt, and peanut butter. And I'm really excited to try it. Oh, it came out so thick. I think I could have added a little bit more of milk. It smells so good. I think I can add some more milk in it. I kind of should. Time to try. Oh my god. I feel like I've been missing out big time not making it earlier. That's gonna be my everyday breakfast now, since I'm really struggling to find high protein breakfast ideas. Because most of them contain eggs and I can't eat eggs because of my stomach issues. So this one right here has probably like 16 grams of protein from yogurt, like 7 grams of protein from milk, from oats and cheese seeds. So this is like very high protein, and peanut butter as well. That's why I feel like this is a very good option for those who can't eat eggs either. I just checked my fridge and I have a lot of fruits and vegetables that are going bad. And I personally hate throwing food away, so I'm just trying to maximize the usage of food that I buy weekly. So I'm thinking maybe I can make some juice today from all the veggies and fruits that I have. And also that's a good opportunity to share a juice recipe with you guys that is so easy to make and is super nutritious. You don't even need a juicer for that. You can just use your blender. It's gonna give you a glowy skin and improve your digestion. And again, it's super easy to make, so just bear with me. Done with cutting my fruits and I added half of pineapple. I just saved the other half for my smoothies. I'm gonna cut this one and just put it in the freezer to use it later. I added one lemon, two apples, cucumber, half of the cucumber, and I still have the other half made for my salads. I think that's pretty much it. I usually add lime too with lemon. I use them together, but I think that's enough acidic content here for my stomach issues. I'm also gonna add some ginger in it and like 100% celery because it's so good for digestion, and kale as well for more greens in it. And I think that's it. Made juices for the next 5 days. I used the other half of the pineapple I had and some mangoes for smoothies. I just cut them in little pieces and just put them in the freezer. I feel super hungry and I'm making some quinoa, maybe with chicken. I'm cleaning all this mess I made from all the juices and food. My dinner is ready and it's some type of quinoa salad, and I used grounded beef instead of chicken, but I wish I had chickpeas or something to add to this quinoa salad because it's looking kind of weird. I hope it just tastes good. I'm just like so hungry. That's good. After the juice, my stomach started hurting so bad because I kind of overused pineapple and ginger, and you know, like I have a very sensitive stomach, like my acidity is high, so I had to like take a medication. It's right here, this one from Puma. This is my favorite one. It just always helps with like upset stomach relief, whenever I have heartburn or just high acidity, the first thing I run to. And I just wanna go like quick over what I put in the salad. I have some lettuce in here, spinach, quinoa, obviously, cucumber, and cherry tomatoes. And for the dressing, I went very simple. I used olive oil and balsamic vinegar, and that's pretty much it. So I'm just like keeping my meals real simple. I basically spent the whole day making juices and just like cooking and stuff, and I forgot that I have a research paper that I need to finish until tomorrow night, but like I just wrote half of it, so I didn't get to clean today, so I'm gonna probably finish my paper and then go walk on a treadmill a little bit and then probably like go to bed since I'm trying to fix my sleeping schedule.
Show my love.